the next flowers in the snow garden is the glory of snow, just properly named. It does bloom in very early spring and will give you beautiful flowers. The colors are lilac blue to violet blue. So for all my paper gardeners who like that touch of blue in their gardening, this is a great one for you. And like the crocus, it goes into dormancy after flowering. So, and it's also a naturalizer. So that means if you plant 10 bulbs the next year, you might have, you know, 20 flowers. It is a perennial and it is a bulb. So it's quite hardy and will last, you know, for a couple of weeks. It looks like a beautiful blue carpet when mine bloom out here, usually in February here. And so if you get a light snow, it's not going to harm them. So you've got leaves and then you've got a six petal flower. So you've got the plate with the, that will cut the two. And then you've got leaves and you can cut two to three of the leaves, whatever. And then the little stamen. The stamen is interesting because it isn't flared out. It's rolled up in quite solid, I guess you would call it. So I'm using, I like the blue, like a periwinkle blue. That's a nice color that mine are in. BV 2.3 is really close. The one thing you want to do is leave the centers white. So we're going to color from the outside of the petal towards the center. And it has this kind of shading no matter what color you blue or lilac that you color it in. It can go very pale lilac, almost like a pinkish lilac, to even a darker blue than this. But it is a violet blue. It's got, you know, it does have purple in it. So I'm gonna color the two pieces, front and back. This is the right side. And then I'll turn it over and color on the wrong side. And I'm just kind of brushing it lightly towards the center, keeping that center white. And you'll see on my project what that looks like in a second. Okay. And then for the leaves, the stamen's gonna stay white. We are going to put some yellow pollen on it, but for the leaves, I'm using YG 8.5 and then YG 2.5. And I'm doing that little bit darker color towards the stem area and then going over it with the more yellowish green to give it that brighter tone color. And let me switch it over here and I'll... I love how the Olos color. They, you know, it saves you some time going through the back because they're so nice and juicy. And look how they blend so well. But here, yeah, so we've got our leaves done. So all the coloring's done, and now we'll go shaping. I'm gonna place these both on my molding mat, and they're right side up. You're gonna use your loop tool. Make sure your loop tool is all the way in. There's that little ball bearing. You wanna go all the way to the top and make sure it's locked in. Now you don't have to, don't press hard, but you're just going to stroke it, each petal from the outside of the petal towards the center. And then I'll do this second one the same way. See, I'm just rubbing a couple of times. Don't have to press hard. I don't want you breaking your loop tool. This is, if you're using the my specialty paper, you don't have to do that. Now you will, I recommend the molding tray. Whoops, got it turned upside down here. And what I'm going to do is pinch these petals, and I might fold down a little bit of a pinch here on the end. And I'm going to do each one the same way. And you notice it's got that circle in the middle, and like the crocus, I want more of what I would call a throat of the flower, like you're looking down into it. So that's how I designed that. You can take the medium ball stylus and cup it And then I'm going to grab some glue here. Doesn't matter which one you put on. It's strictly, you know what? I'm going to just cup that one a little better here. There. I want to get that kind of rounded edge there. And I'm just going to paint the glue using my tool here. This comes with the glue pot. And then you'll notice there's two petals and one petal. This is the same thing here. You want, here's the one, the top petal here. And so you want the two petals to go with that. And the one down. Now get the glue off. I'm going to put it in my, move some of this out of the way, into the quarter inch. And I'm going to use that small ball stylus just to gradually push it down a little bit. I want to maintain that throat. And as you can see, what I'm doing is kind of spreading the petals out. So if I hold this up closer, you can see I've made like a little dent in that, or, you know, a rounded little hole. We're going to let that set there for a little bit, and I'm going to put it aside. And then I'm going to show you how I do the stamen. So like I said, the stamen is left white. And just take some glue and paint right along the base. It's a very fine stamen, and it's rolled up tightly. And like I said, usually on my stamen, I take my finger and fluff it out. I'm not going to do that this time, but I am going to put glue on the end, and this has yellow pollen on it. So it should look just like that, as if it's a tight cluster of filaments there. Now, while it's sitting in the tray here, I can go ahead and put that stamen right down into that center there. And next, we'll do the leaves. So I'm going to bring in my leaf pad and my leaf tool. And I'm going to place these right side down. And then I'm just going to draw a stamen line down the center. And bend up on it a little bit. If it's, these are a little finer, so you can use your tweezers to bend it. And then I'm going to bend it back again. I just want to create that crease. And then I'm going to use just a fine liner pen and draw that line up the center, just lightly doing it. You can see how the crease came out nicely. So you can do 2 to 3 of these, and if you like, you can add a little bit of definition to the end by scrunching it back a little bit. And like I said, this will be a nice addition to your bouquets because of the small, tiny flowers that they are, plus they are that lovely blue color. Great for spring. So I paired it with my American holly. I'm going to take it out of the tray, and you can see how it's got that throat or indentation there, and I'm just going to set it down on my card here. I've done a little bouquet. I like using the American holly. It's not just for Christmas. I mean, my American holly is blooming right now, and it's got green berries, which would be pretty, but I love the addition of the little bit of red with this, these bright blue flowers. Let's see, now I can go in here and add those lovely leaves. What a beautiful bouquet that is now. Very simple. And then, you know, kindness is like snow. It beautifies everything it covers. Well, it will not hurt your glory of snow. One last thing, and then we'll be all done. So, of course, got to add a little ladybug. So I'm just going to dip her a little bit in glue here and add her onto a leaf. She would probably still be in hibernation, but just in case it's gotten a little warm out, she's checking out and making sure there's no aphids on my flowers. So I'm going to use some of this glazing glue by Spellbinders just to add a little bit of shine to her. There we go. And that's it. That's the glory of snow. It's probably one you haven't heard of, but I bet it's going to be one of your favorites.